today on Fatmann Makes, as part of the Pwnagotchi build series, we're going to be covering pcap to hccapx for Hashcat use. Be sure to enter your Pwnagotchi into the Pwnagotchi build contest. All you have to do is send me a pwn mail from your Pwnagotchi and you'll be entered into the contest. See the description for details. Click subscribe and ring that bell so you get notifications of new videos and get contest updates. This video is for educational purposes only. Guys, make sure you test responsibly. Welcome guys to Fatmann Makes and Breaks. So today we are going to cover what to do with your Pwnagotchi handshakes. If you missed my last video, there should be a pop-up at the top corner here if you want to check it out. We covered the Pwnagetty script / plugin, which automatically downloaded your handshake files from your Pwnagotchi and converted them into a Hashcat usable file. So today we're going to look at doing this conversion without having to do any other major installs. It would all happen within Windows, utilizing as much as the Windows environment as we can. That's what we're going to get into today. And first off, we are going to be running a PowerShell script to do this. And I just want to state for the record, I am not a coder. So I'm sure the coders out there could code this a lot cleaner than it is, but it's functional for me and really that's all that matters. So if anybody wants to make changes or suggestions, feel free to shoot them over to me and I'll take a look at them. So we're going to start off with the basics here. We are going to have a working directory. And this working directory here is within my Hashcat folder. So obviously, ultimately, we're going to be using Hashcat to run an attack against these files after we're done. So why not stick them here? So the only caveats or the only requirements that we need is this one executable cap to hccapx.exe, and this is part of the Hashcat utilities program. I covered how to download this and install this in the original pcap video that I created. See this pop up in the top here if you want more details, but there will be a link in the description also to that website. So we need to create an empty folder called merged, and then we need to drop that executable here in this working directory. There will be a pastebin file in the description that will contain this PowerShell script. You just need to copy it and paste it into this directory, and we can do that right now. So you just want to create a new text document, call it whatever you want. As you see, I called it pcap-convert.ps1. So you just need to make sure that you name it .ps1. So if this was an example, right, of what you named it, we're going to say yes here. That's what I named it. You double click on it, it'll open up in Notepad, and then you just paste in that pastebin text and then do a file save and you can close it out. All right, so obviously the file already exists here for me. So let's take a look at that. All right, and here's the file. So we just have a couple variables specified here. A get location just to get the location of the PowerShell script. The program that we're calling is this cap2hccapx.exe file. And then the meat and potatoes is this one loop here. So we're basically getting all the files in the directory here, and we're filtering by pcap. So it's only going to apply to the pcap files. And then it's going to basically read the file name, and then it's going to run the conversion process, and then it's going to rename it to the base name of the file .hccapx. And then right here, we are basically doing a little error correction here to make sure that there's actually usable handshakes in the file. If there are not, it's going to create a file called incomplete.txt, and it's going to put the names of the files that weren't usable in this text file. And we're going to utilize that file in another video to see if we can extract any data from those files and still use that information to run a crack. So, and then the next thing that it's going to do here is if that file wasn't usable, it's going to purge that HCCAPX file that it originally created because it's not useful. Once all of that is done for all of the files, we're going to run a simple merge here. It's running a binary copy, and it's going to run that against all HCCAPX files, and it's going to create a file called multi.2500, and it's going to insert in the merged directory that we created. So you might ask, why am I naming this file .2500? Because this is the hash mode that you would use in Hashcat, i.e. the dash M number. When you're dealing with a lot of these files and you're extracting different types of hashes, by naming the file the number that you need to use within Hashcat alleviates some confusion. So in a nutshell, that's the file, and we just need some data here. So let me grab some test data. And again, all these files are test files from my lab. So we have a bunch of files in here. I have a couple listed as bad one, bad two. So we know that we're gonna get some bad data. And then, all right, if we open a command prompt, we just need to call that PowerShell file. And this is how we're gonna do it. We're specifying PowerShell dash execution policy bypass dash file dot backslash, and then the name of the PowerShell script file. In this case, it's pcap dash convert.ps1. We hit enter here. We see that it converted these files here. And then this one copy right here is the merge. So now if we look and we sort by file type here, we can see here's the pcap, original pcap files that we had. Here's the hccapx files that it just created. And then in the merge folder, we have this multi.2500 file, which is all of these combined into one file. And then if we look at the incomplete.txt file, and we can see these files here didn't have enough handshake data in them to be usable. So we wrote them to this file, and hopefully we can utilize this information later in a different video. And basically that's it. The only other thing we need to do here is copy that multi file into our Hashcat directory. So we're going to copy merged subfolder and then the file multi.2500 space dot dot backslash multi.2500. If we cd dot dot to move up to our Hashcat directory. All right, now that we're in the Hashcat directory, we can call the executable that we need. hashcat64.exe-m2500. See the correlation? This is 2500 is the hash mode that we're using, and then we're specifying the file that we just created, multi.2500, and then we're specifying the dictionary that we're using for the dictionary attack is rocku, and if we hit enter here, all right, and look, we're already getting results here. It's cracked this SSID. The password is welcome too. If we hit S here for status, look, we got another one. Fatmann makes summer of 69. Again, if we hit a status here, we can see it's still running against the multi.2500. It's using the RockU file, and we have 48 passwords. It's been running for 23 seconds, and there's 2 hours and 39 minutes left. So this is not running on my main computer. This is just running on my test lab computer. And you can see here, if we scroll all the way up, the device that it's using is a very old GeForce GT710. So that is a pretty slow video card in regards to GPU cracking. And we can tell that here, we can see that it takes roughly 2 hours and 40 minutes for it to run through this dictionary file straight. No rules or anything like that. Let's just get some time frames. So for a single hash, all right, so for a single hash, well, there's 8 hashes, but it's really one network, so it's only gonna have to run it once. We can see it's gonna take 43 minutes to get through the RockU file on this GPU, and my primary GPU in general can do this under two and a half, three minutes. So that's the difference of a fairly decent GPU versus a really old GPU. Now, if you're doing this on your CPU, it's going to be even slower. So something to note when you're doing stuff like this.